Imagine waking up one day to the shocking news that your favorite singer, the legendary Elvis Presley, has passed away. It's like a punch to the gut, leaving fans in disbelief and searching for answers. But what if the truth behind his death was even more shocking and mysterious than anyone could have imagined? On August 16, 1977, the world received the devastating news of Elvis' sudden death. Fans were left heartbroken, and the city of Memphis became a sea of grief. The outpouring of love and support was unprecedented, with flowers flooding in from all corners of the country. FTD, a florist's delivery service, experienced its busiest day ever, a testament to the impact Elvis had on people's lives. The arrangements that arrived were not just ordinary flowers. They were shaped into symbols that represented Elvis' life and legacy: lightning bolts, guitars, hound dogs, and stars. It was as if each flower carried a piece of the fans' hearts, hoping to honor their beloved idol. Elvis' body was brought back to his home, Graceland, for a private viewing with his family and close friends. The atmosphere was somber, with tears and quiet reflections filling the air. But the public wanted a chance to say goodbye too, and so a viewing was arranged for the afternoon. Thousands of fans, young and old, gathered at Graceland, hoping for a glimpse of their hero one last time. The line stretched for miles, with people patiently waiting to pay their respects. It was a powerful display of love and admiration, but not everyone would get the chance to see Elvis. As the gates closed, over 85,000 fans had passed by, their eyes filled with emotion. Some cried openly, while others held back their tears, but the impact of Elvis' death was felt by all. It was a moment that united people from different walks of life, bringing them together in their grief. The funeral of Elvis Presley was an event like no other. Celebrities and close friends gathered to bid farewell to the king of rock and roll. Among them were Caroline Kennedy, Chet Atkins, and Margaret, George Hamilton, and Jackie Kahane, all shocked by the behavior of Colonel Parker, Elvis' longtime manager. Parker's actions were bizarre and inappropriate. He refused to be a pallbearer, opting for a loud Hawaiian shirt and a baseball cap instead. It was as if he was making a mockery of the solemn occasion. As the gates of Graceland opened, a white Cadillac hearse emerged, followed by a long line of limousines. The fans lining the streets, their faces sunburned from grief, witnessed a sight they never thought they'd see. Elvis' final ride was a somber procession, with flags flying at half-mast as ordered by the Tennessee governor. It was a moment of silence and reflection, but some mourners knew more than they were letting on. The official cause of Elvis' death, as stated by Dr. Jerry Francisco, was cardiac arrhythmia. But this simple explanation raised more questions than it answered. How could a seasoned medical examiner make such a statement without proper examination and test results? Cardiac arrhythmia sounded like a fancy term, but it essentially meant an irregular heartbeat. And for Francisco to diagnose this, Elvis' heart would have to be beating a detail that seemed to have been overlooked. The media, eager for answers, swallowed this explanation, but it left a bad taste in the mouths of many. People tend to believe the first version of a story they hear, even if it's not entirely accurate. This phenomenon, known as the first impression effect, was evident in how the media and the public accepted Francisco's diagnosis. It was a convenient explanation, and so it stuck. Just like the belief that Bill Clinton claimed to have smoked marijuana but didn't inhale, people often cling to the initial narrative, even if it's later proven false. In a world where information spreads rapidly, critical thinking and fact-checking can sometimes take a back seat. It wasn't until ABC News and Geraldo Rivera, with the help of James Cole and Charles Thompson, investigated Elvis' death that the real picture began to emerge. Their research, presented on the show 20/20, shed light on the many inconsistencies and lies surrounding the official story. Dan Warlick, in his work, The Death of Elvis, called Francisco's statements total, complete, unmitigated bullshit. By interviewing those involved in the autopsy, Warlick revealed the grim truth: everyone had been misled. The true cause of Elvis' death, cardiac arrhythmia, was a vague and unconvincing explanation. It suggested a stopped heart, but it failed to address the underlying cardiovascular issues Elvis was known to have. The puzzle pieces didn't fit, and the real story was far more complex. The death of Elvis Presley remains a topic of fascination and speculation to this day. His impact on music and popular culture is undeniable, but the circumstances surrounding his passing continue to intrigue and confuse. As we reflect on this iconic figure's life and untimely demise, we are left with more questions than answers. Was it truly an accidental overdose, as some suggest? Or was there more to the story hidden beneath the surface? The mystery of Elvis' death serves as a reminder that sometimes the truth is stranger than fiction. It invites us to question, to seek out the facts, and to never settle for simple explanations when the reality might be far more intriguing. And so, as we remember Elvis, let us also remember the power of critical thinking and the importance of seeking the truth, no matter how shocking or unexpected it may be.